You look pretty jerk. Okay, so we're in, do you know what town this is?
No.
No? Well,
we're on the border of Virginia and North Carolina, though.
We're an hour and 45 minutes in, and we saw Bojangles. So we are stopping to get Bo-Bear biscuits, and then we will continue our trip. So we'll be in Lexington in about 2 hours and 25 minutes. So we're about 45 minutes away from the parking lot. Part of our hike is going to be on the Appalachian Trail, so that'll be kind of cool. There's also a waterfall that we're going to, and it should be about 8 miles total, and then I think we're going to try and go up the hill, because we're walking all the way around a big hill. So it's got creeks on all sides, and hopefully we'll walk up and camp tomorrow night on top of the hill. So we're just now getting into the kind of the rolling hills and a little bit more windy roads, so we not too much longer we'll be there. Every time you get the camera out, we miss our view. You might get a shot of the railroad track right here. Well, maybe not. We got a little bit of fog rolling in. Got the railroad track and the river down there.
Where he told them to make piggy noises and squeal. We're right about that area.
Getting on the Blue Ridge Parkway, and we are about 15 minutes out. What do you think land of many users means?
You're doing a lot of activities on this land.
It's a little bit weird.
Yeah, very suggestive.
Ends.
This road just abruptly ends.
Yeah, it's paved though, I'm surprised.
Only 20 miles an hour.
I thought, we haven't been on gravel yet. Well, apparently they have a bigger budget up here at the Jefferson National Forest than they do down in Pisgah. Yeah. They can actually pave their dang roads. It is two lanes.
It's very nice. Highfalutin.
Right next to the creek. I'm impressed with how well maintained everything is. Like even this gravel road, you can tell it's been graded. Very recently. I hope nobody's coming out the other way, though, because there is no getting around. I think nobody's coming out at 11 o'clock in the morning.
We shall see.
But, I mean, there's not even a pullover spot. I mean, it's just steep shoulder on both sides. Maybe there. Yeah, there you go.
We have made it.
That worked out well. Normally, these forest roads are hard to figure out, but it seems very well marked, so cool. Okay, so we made it to the parking lot, and this is Jefferson National Forest. Pretty nice setup. They've got a kiosk over there and a footbridge, so we'll have to figure out what trailhead specifically to get on. But I'm going to bring you in here, and I'll show you what loop we're going to be doing. So this is the green is the Appalachian Trail, and so part of our loop is actually going to be on the Appalachian Trail. We're starting up here at this parking lot. We're going to come down this trail, which should be number 17, is Apple Orchard Falls. We're going to try and make the falls tonight, and then in the morning we'll get up and we'll get on the Appalachian Trail. We'll hike the Appalachian Trail around to trail number 18, which is Cornelius Creek, and we'll take that up and we'll try and scoot up onto the ridge sometime tomorrow evening, and we'll make camp up on top, and then we'll come out, come down the hill, and leave on the third day. So that's kind of our plan. It's kind of a blown up version of it, but we've got two options here. This is either a road, or it says it's trail 18A on this map, so we might take this if we decide that it's too much hiking and it's too steep or whatever, but we're going to try and make it down to the Appalachian Trail, since that'll be kind of cool to get on that for a little while. So anyway, that's our plan. We have water around us the whole loop, so really it shouldn't be that bad finding water. So we're going to go ahead and get rucked up and get on the trail. Yeah, so we've hiked about an hour now. We're probably two-thirds of the way to the falls. This is the shortest hiking day because we want to camp at the falls tonight, so tomorrow we'll probably have maybe double or a little less than double what we're doing today. Today's not bad at all, so, which is good because I haven't done this in a long time. What do you think, Jared?
Well, I can hear water.
Yeah, water's right over there.
Very nice trail.
Yeah, it's very well kept. We were talking about that. They've got signs well posted, and they've blazed it well, and it's a lot more upkept than Pisgah was. Mm-hmm. Pisgah, we backtracked probably not far, but at least 7 or 8 times. Because we couldn't figure out where to go. So this one is pretty obvious. And we actually have a map this time.
Somebody took an axe to it?
Looks like somebody took an axe to it.
Shaft.
Yeah, you can see those are like axe chops. Idiots.
Yeah. Okay. That's a lot of waiting time.
Just say 2000, like it was put here in 2000. I feel bad for the dude that had to lug this crap in here.
Board by board.
Do you think they, yeah, I mean, they had to bring the nails and stuff. Man, that would suck. That is a cool view right there. That tree is blocking it, but the top is way up there. That's like a perfectly vertical wall way up there.
You gotta play some water for it, somebody.
Yes, it would.
Luckily, I'm not even that wet, dude. I don't have a lot of smoke on it. Well, my back, I do.
Yeah, my shoulders.
Generally, like armpits and back, that's pretty much it. Not losing a lot of water weight.
Alright, so there is a view just through the brush right here of the whole mountain. So you can see blue sky right here. We're going to try and walk down this bridge and get up here somewhere. Hopefully it's flat enough we can camp so we can have that big view tonight. That would be awesome.
Part of the trail is right there. I'm looking at it.
There's a trail right through there, yeah. I want to go up there, yeah. So let's walk around, dump our packs in the woods a little bit, and then bushwhack if we need to, looks like up there. This is the second best view I've had on a backpacking trip. The best one was the one I was trying to take you, the one I was trying to take you guys on last time.
Uh-huh.
And we ended up coming in the wrong way. But that one you could see for just miles, and you could see the falls and all that. That was a cool one. But this is cool. We're gonna be able to camp here tonight, which is the best part.
Yep.
We're gonna be able to see that tonight.
You could perhaps tonight.
Yeah, I feel like up these stairs a little bit, it flattens out enough that, I don't know. You want dumper packs here and then do some scouting?
Yeah.
Okay, so we found a very nice campsite. We have our view behind us that we were looking for. We have access to water. We're within, you know, 50 yards of the falls, of the actual falls. We have an even closer access to the creek itself. It might be a separate creek. We'll have to see when we look. It's not too far away at all. We have dry firewood. We already have a good clearing. It's up out of the way from people. We shouldn't have anybody even see where we're at. So we just have to bring our packs up these steps. And the hardest part is gonna be getting up there the first time with our rucks. And then after that, we've already got our access to water, so we shouldn't have to come down again until evening when we wanna go hang out by the waterfall. So really, really good campsite. And so we're gonna take you up there now. We're gonna go ahead and put our pant legs on while we're clearing out camp so we don't get caught up in any poison ivy or anything. So anyway, that's where we're at. That's where I'll be hanging my hammock. There's our fire pit we made. There's Jared set up. He's gonna go that tree to this tree. And I'm making spaghetti for lunch. Late lunch. Okay, so here's our camp. We had our tarp set up a little bit differently, but as you guys can probably see, the clouds are rolling in, the wind's kicking up, starting to feel a few drops, so we kind of tucked our tarps down a little bit lower. Got my pack with a pack cover on it underneath, because by the looks of it, we're going to get a little bit of a storm coming through here. So we're going to take our stuff down that from lunch and wash it in the creek, and then put it under our tarps. Maybe we can collect a little bit of rainwater so we don't have to purify so much later. So that's the plan for now. We'll keep you updated. So we went down to the creek. It's not too far away at all. Thankfully, I didn't realize it, but we kind of walked around to the top of the falls. It was quite a bit uphill. So we're kind of at the top of the falls. We got a nice little swimming pool area But we're not going to be swimming because it's, you know, May 10th and the water's freaking cold. I mean, you can barely keep your hands in there for too long before they start going numb. So I just felt the raindrop just now. So we're going to start getting rain probably any second. The wind's kicked up. Yep, I'm feeling rain right now. So we're about to just sit it out. And hopefully it'll pass before dinner time so we can get a fire going and cook some dinner up. But you can see the wind in the trees. I mean, it's got that feel of a storm for sure. So we'll keep you updated.